As President Trump threatened to fire off a letter today from the White House saying that White House lawyers will not cooperate until House Democrats hold a vote on their impeachment inquiry. We are just finding out now that letter may not be coming from the White House until Monday at the earliest, and that there is a bit of an internal debate going on inside the president's impeachment team as to whether or not to fire off that letter. Now, as for this request, for information from Vice President Mike Pence, his office has just responded with a statement saying that this request for documents and other information, quote, does not appear to be a serious request. And so the Vice President's office is now knocking that down. There's a quote there from Katie Waldman, the Vice President's press secretary. But President Trump, he was in full damage control mode today, Wolf, cleaning up his plea for China and Ukraine to dig up dirt on Joe Biden. His performance today here at the White House seemed aimed at fending off these charges that he's seeking the assistance of foreign countries to help him in his reelection bid in 2020. The president, the problem, though, for him is that he's already made this plea in front of the cameras.
With mounting evidence he solicited foreign interference in the 2020 election, President Trump is changing his story, insisting he's now more interested in rooting out corruption than investigating former Vice President Joe Biden.
I don't care about Biden's campaign, but I do care about corruption. His campaign, that's up to him. Politics, that's up to them. I don't care about politics. So we are looking at corruption. We're not looking at politics. We're looking at corruption.
But that's not how the president laid it out the day before, when he directly called on Ukraine and China to dig up some Biden family dirt.
It's a very simple answer. They should investigate the Bidens. By the way, likewise, China should start an investigation into the Bidens, because what happened in China is just about as bad as what happened with Ukraine.
Now the president is claiming he never thought Biden would win the Democratic nomination.
I think he'd be an easy opponent, but I never thought Biden was going to win. I don't care about politics, but I do care about corruption.
And Mr. Trump could not answer whether he was seeking corruption probes in foreign countries that don't include Democratic candidates.
Have you asked foreign leaders for any corruption investigations that don't involve your political opponent? That is, are there other cases where
we would have to look.
So far, at least one Republican is not buying it. As Utah Senator Mitt Romney tweeted, by all appearances, the president's brazen and unprecedented appeal to China and to Ukraine to investigate Joe Biden is wrong and appalling. But Romney is mostly alone in the GOP. Florida Senator Marco Rubio tells CNN affiliate WFOR Mr. Trump is just trolling the media.
I don't know if that's a real request or him just needling the press, knowing that you guys were going to get outraged by it. He's pretty good at getting everybody fired up, and he's been doing that for a while, and the media responded right on task.
That may explain why the president is confident the Republican-controlled Senate will hold its ground and keep Mr. Trump in office if House Democrats vote to impeach.
They have no choice. They have to follow their leadership. And then we'll get it to the Senate, and we're going to win. The Republicans have been very unified.
But the impeachment inquiry has found its way to congressional town halls. Iowa's Joni Ernst got an earful at one in her state.
Where is the line? When are you guys going to say enough?
Yeah, good question. So,
aren't you breaking the law asking for foreign help?
The president is also not answering whether he had violated the law. The chair of the Federal Election Commission says the law is clear. It is illegal for any person to solicit, accept, or receive anything of value from a foreign national in connection with a U.S. election. Mr. Trump appears to be relishing his latest firestorm, claiming his battles with the media have invigorated the Christian faith.
I got a call the other night from pastors, the biggest pastors, evangelical Christians. They said, we have never seen our religion or any religion so electrified.
The president is describing the latest job numbers in almost biblical terms.
Asia is doing poorly, to put it mildly, and we continue to do very well with the miracle.
Now, the president says none of this has to do with politics, but it's worth noting he is now fundraising off of the Bidens for days, as well as this impeachment probe. And Mr. Trump has been telling his allies he doesn't believe he's done anything wrong and seeking foreign help for his reelection next year. A source close to the White House who has spoken with the president in recent days says the president is, quote, going for broke.